Hi, and welcome to another moment with Mike and Lois.
Hi.
So we're talking about Gideon, and one of the first challenges he had to face was really to test whether he would go to the lengths that God was asking him to really prove that he would face those challenges, what he was willing to face.
Right.
And it's not that God doesn't know what we're willing to face, but we don't know what we're willing to face.
Yeah.
So the test is not so much that God needs to find out, but he needs us to find out what we're prepared to do and the lengths we're prepared to go.
Yeah.
So he sets up this test where he basically asks Gideon to pull down his dad's idol worship altar and idol worship materials. You know, the Asherah pole was one of those things.
Yeah.
And we might feel like that's a bit of a foreign kind of thing. You know, we don't kind of get that. But just think of idols. And you know, this was a challenge for Gideon because he was really dicing with danger here. And we know the reaction was that the whole of the area came out and asked for him to be killed because of what he'd done.
Yeah.
But it really does prove a point, doesn't it? That really Jesus referred to when he was talking to us about it as well.
You know, and I know you can't possibly believe that potentially your family could be used. But it does actually say, and Jesus himself says, in Matthew 10 verse 36, it says, your enemies will be right in your own household. Now that's a scary thought to start with. And I know you don't even want to think about it because you don't want to think that potentially anybody in your family could, any one of them could be holding you back.
Well, and like we were saying on Sunday, don't go now looking at your husband, wife or kids for horns sticking out their head.
Or tails,
but
or,
hey,
you know,
if they have got them sticking out your head, well, you need to do something.
Yeah. But seriously, we have to look at what or who is holding us back in life. Holding us back from being all that God wants us to be. Holding us back from being the conqueror. Because it may well be that the enemy is in your own household.
Right. And you know, we see it all the time.
Yeah.
In church life, we see it all the time. That there are people, it could be kids holding you back. It could be your spouse holding you back. It could be beyond that in your greater family. And you know, it might not even be that those people necessarily know that they're doing it to you. It might be their own insecurities that are causing them to advise you or to caution you or to slow you down or to give you bad advice. Or actually sometimes they are just jealous, they're insecure, and through their own insecurities and jealousies they're affecting you. And you know, what we have to do is face up to the reality of what and who is holding us back.
Yeah.
And if that's family, we have to deal with it.
Yes, you do. It's a reality check. You have to be honest with yourself.
Right.
And honest with your situation and say, well, what is holding you back? Each time you want to step forward, take strides forward, you don't seem to get anywhere. Well, what is holding you back?
Yeah.
Or who is holding you back?
Well,
because until you deal with that, it will never change.
Yeah, I mean, in any relationship, there's going to be one that's going to have more faith than the other, and there's going to be one that's going to have more wisdom than the other.
Mm-hmm.
And hopefully that combination should work, but sometimes it can have an adverse effect because maybe the person who's more cautious, who we would call wise, but sometimes we really mistake that for caution, won't move forward when God says move forward. So, you know, it's holding that other person back from being all that they're called to be.
Yeah.
So sometimes we just got to take the bull by the horns, if you pardon the pun, and just go for it and deal with the consequences.
Yeah.
And as we saw with Gideon's story, God will protect you.
That's what he had to do.
Yeah. Do whatever you need to do. That's a good saying to end up on today. Well, we'll be back tomorrow with another moment. So have a great day. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.